Hey guys, welcome back. And you probably would have seen me in this makeup and this outfit over a few videos because I'm pre-filming a bunch of videos right now since I'm going to be quite busy in the next couple of days. So I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to make any videos until then. So I thought, let me go ahead and do this. Now, a little bit of an update. As you guys know, I have been on a low buy for the last year and a half since discovering anti-haul, and I haven't been reviewing many makeup, I haven't been doing a lot of hauls, so I've been thinking, what should I be discussing on my YouTube channel? And I thought, you know what? I think I know. I've been thinking about this for a while, and you probably would have seen the changes gradually happen in my videos, wherein I'm more focused about talking about conscious consumerism, about anti-hauling, about why I don't buy certain products or why I'm not interested in certain releases. So yeah, you would have seen me do like a will I buy it video or something like that. Yeah. And the reason behind that is, like I said, I'm trying to be a little bit more of a conscious consumer. So I will probably be doing a bit more of those talky videos, and let me know if this is something that you're interested in listening to. And these are obviously just my own opinions, my own personal experiences. And yeah, so here we go. The first thing that I want to talk about, and I think this was inspired by me seeing a video of Angelica Nickist a couple of months back when I first discovered her. My lash extensions are going haywire. Anyway, when I first discovered her, she talked about why she's okay with not being able to return makeup in Sweden. And I thought, you know what? I am also actually grateful that I can't return makeup here in Australia. Like, here in Australia, once you've opened it and the seal is broken, you can't return it anymore, okay? And I'll tell you why I'm okay with that. In line with my thoughts and feelings about conscious consumerism, I'm grateful that I'm not able to return makeup here in Australia because, one, it makes me really think about the purchase that I am about to make, because I know that I can't return it, that I'm gonna have to keep it or declutter it or pass it on to somebody else. I am more conscious about the cost of the particular makeup, whether I am actually going to get my money's worth out of it, if I am going to be using it as often, so that I could get my money's worth out of it. I really have to think about, is this something that I need in my collection? Is this something that I can live without? Obviously I can, because it's makeup, you know, but it really gets me to think about my purchases and whether it's something that I can do without. So that's one of the reasons why I like that I can't return makeup here in Australia, because it really, like, I have to think about it many, 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 many times before I will do it, you know? I have to look at my collection and say, do I already have these shades in here? If I am only looking at a palette because of one or two shades, maybe I can buy them in singles instead of buying the whole palette and having the rest of them unused, you know? It really makes me realize, okay, what I need to do to be a more conscious consumer. Number two, not being able to return makeup here in Australia means there's less wastage, because if you return makeup, I know that in the US you can return makeup even if you've already used it, they can't resell that makeup for hygiene purposes. So where does that makeup go? It goes into the bins. It goes into the trash. You probably would have seen videos about dumpster dives, about makeup being thrown into the bins and people actually going into the garbage bins and then taking those makeups. Some of them have been swatched, some of them were used as testers, some of them were returned items, and because they're not allowed to resell that, or they can't, mostly because of hygiene purposes, that's a lot of waste. And especially because now all of these bulky packaging of these makeup, okay, they're not always recyclable, you know? That's why I don't mind cardboard packaging on makeup, because that you can recycle, right? And you can take out the pans and recycle that as well. But if you've got like all of these plastic, you know, containers, then it might, you know, it's just gonna go into landfills, creating even more pollution. It's probably going to go into the ocean, like those microplastics are going to go into the ocean, gonna get eaten by sea life, which we in turn eat. So we're poisoning ourselves by doing that, you know? Which is why I've also come to the conclusion that after I've used up a lot of my products, like my toiletries and stuff like that, I'm gonna start buying products that don't come in containers, like buying in bulk, so that I may not be zero waste, but it would be a sharp decrease in my recyclables or in my landfill bins. Because I just feel like, especially when I went to Bali for my wedding and I saw all of that garbage floating into the ocean in Nusa Dua, I was like, this is wrong, and this is our fault, you know. Another reason why I am happy that I can't return makeup here in Australia is because I think that it sort of creates a supply and demand issue with manufacturers if their items are not being bought, because people are being a little bit more conscious about their buying. So a lot of the stock remains in the store, and then it kind of like filters through the economic cycle of supply and demand, that if there's still a lot of supply and not a lot of demand, then maybe these companies would actually think more about the products that they are coming out if it is something that the consumers actually want. And if it's not, then perhaps it's not something that they should be releasing anymore. And I think it then makes the quality of products better, the choices and variety better. It sort of like gives people the idea that our manufacturers or producers or like this big makeup companies the idea that, okay, so that's not a big thing, it's not a trend, it's not working, it's not selling, so maybe we have to look at something else. I feel like if I was the one making these makeup, it would make me think, well, let's be a little bit more innovative, let's stop churning out all of these warm neutral palettes that people are not buying anymore because the market is saturated with warm neutral palettes, right? So I feel like it's a good way, and it's a good direction to go when people are a little bit more conscious about their consumerism, when people are a little bit more aware of their purchases and whether or not it is necessary for them to make that purchase. It impacts the economy, it impacts how manufacturers of these products think about their product releases, and whether it's just the same thing over and over again, or if it's something that they can improve upon, you know? So those are like some of the reasons why I think it's okay that I can't return makeup here in Australia. The main reason being that it really, really does make me think about whether my money should go into that product. Alright, let me know in the comment section down below, in your country, wherever you're watching me from, are you able to return makeup? And if you are, do you do it often? If you are not, how do you feel about not being able to return makeup? And if you do not return makeup, even if you can return them, why not? Okay, I think this is going to be a good discussion point. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next video. If you haven't subscribed, please do and click on the notification bell so that you are aware of when I upload my videos, which is usually Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays.